Getty Edward Guttnacht, Energy Eddie, in action against George Grevis, and it shames me to say that it feels as though boxing has done nothing about it. On November 18 last year, he came to Wembley Arena to take on George Groves, the reinvigorated Brit boxing under a new coach, Shane McGuigan, gunning for a fourth world title shot. Twice beaten by Carl Froch and once by Badou Jack, he was determined that nothing would stop him in his quest to reign the super middleweight division. And indeed on that night, nothing did. Groves produced an excellent display of boxing but was not able to stop Guttnacht and had to rely on the judge's scorecards. There was no doubt he had won. Two of the judges gave him all but one round, the other giving him 10 rounds and scored one of them a draw. His German opponent looked a beaten man, a huge swelling over his right eye leaving him pretty much unable to see referee Terry O'Connor, who had allowed the fight to reach the final bell. He wearily made his way out of the ring and back to the dressing room to begin the process of recovering from a bruising 36 minutes of championship boxing. But when he got there, he collapsed and was rushed to the hospital. Guttnacht had surgery to relieve the pressure from a bleed on the brain and was sedated. 5 weeks later, he woke up but had almost no normal function at all. Before Grove made his first return to the ring on the Kell Brook vs. Errol Spence Jr. undercard in May this year, Guttnacht's wife Julia gave a heart-wrenchingly candid interview in Germany. She spoke of being unable to watch the latter stages of the fight and how she is haunted by the thought that had it been stopped early, he might not be in the state he is now. Getty George Groves admits he is still affected by she spoke of what that state now is. He has made little progress and remains unable to walk or talk. He is a father of three young children, all under the age of 8, with whom he cannot properly communicate, and the family have been bankrupted by his condition. There are no professional societies for boxers, Julia said. There is no pension funded by boxing or the like. To my support, my sister moved to me. I am now looking for a job for some hours, depending on the possibility. What I could sell, I sold. Getty George Groves beat Fedor Chudinov but dedicated the victory to Eduard Guttnacht. She even included her bank details at the bottom of the interview so that any wanting to send money to help Guttnacht's recovery and his family could do so. There was a fundraising campaign run by a university in Potsdam in Germany where the boxer had studied, but it pales into insignificance when you consider the magnitude of his injuries. I swear to you, he will come to this hall sometime, and thank you very much, Guttnacht's father said, accepting a check for a few thousand pounds. We hope and do not lose hope. We must hope further. He is the father of three children. But there is a reticence, it seems, to talk about Guttnacht. He is an integral part in the story of one of Britain's favorite boxers, and yet it is though his injuries are collateral damage, a necessarily evil to give the sport its edge. When Grove stepped back into the ring at Bramall Lane, Sky Sports mentioned him in passing, but nothing more. The boxer himself has at least been asked about the tragedy, but only in the context of how it has affected his own sport. When I fought Fedor Chudinov for the world title, it was my first one after Guttnacht, he said this week. I can remember it quite clearly. There's a definite break where he comes in. He doesn't have the ability to tie me up, but he ends up underneath my arm and I look at the ref, and I'm almost looking at him as if to say, what do you reckon, eh? But breath, and obviously we break, and then I catch him with 3, 4, 5 punches and then it's over. And then I remember thinking, I'm happy about that. I do not wish to attach any blame to Groves himself, of course. After beating Chudinov, he spoke of his sympathy for Guttnacht's family, although it felt as though the promoters winced when he did, not wanting the truth to disrupt their clean, above-board event. Saturday, May 2, 2015, Mike Tyson bites Evander Holyfield on the left ear in the third round of their WBA heavyweight match at the MGM Grand in Las Vegas in 1997. Maybe they have a point. Everyone takes a risk when they step into the ring, and they acknowledge that, by doing so. That's why it's so watchable. That's why the biggest punchers sell the most tickets. All sport is played and performed on the edge of what is possible. But boxing is a sport of speed, skill, controlled aggression, defensive shrewdness and respect. The referee exists both to enforce the rules and to protect a fighter who is well beaten. It may be that the referee on that night got it wrong and should have stopped it early. Perhaps he didn't, and Guttnacht got unlucky. His nickname of Energy Eddie worked against him as he continued to bounce on his feet even in the last round. But whatever the truth, there is an irrefutable fact now, that a man, a husband, a father has been left with life-changing injuries, and those who make millions from men and women who are willing to risk the same do nothing to help.